This is the latest picture of Kennedy Shamalla to emerge from Akobo, South Sudan. He was the co-pilot of Captain Frank Njoroge, also captured in this picture. The two have been in detention in the volatile rebel-held region of Akobo after their plane crash-landed. The crash resulted in the death of a local resident who was on the ground and 11 cows. Several houses were also damaged. The community decided to detain the two until they have been compensated for the losses incurred, 14 million shillings in total. Shamalla's wife, Beth Mudoni, ponders her next move.
The governor sends communication that the community needs the compensation. And the only reason the governor of that area is holding them, not really like hostages, keeping them, is because the community has decided it's the only way they're going to get compensation.
She has not seen her husband since he left for South Sudan in late December. Odd that the two pilots survived this horrific crash which burnt the plane to ashes, only to be detained by the residents of Akobo. Tired of the delays from the government and the insurer of the plane, the relatives of the pilots are taking matters into their own hands.
We're going to have an M-Pesa pay bill number by tomorrow because they decided if it's taking this long, we don't know how much more time it's going to take before any action, any serious action is taken. So we want to start contribution, receiving contribution to see what we can do, if we can manage to settle it, because insurance and government, it's really taking a long time.
They are being hasty for a reason. Mudoni has not spoken to Shamalla directly for 2 weeks now. This is because of the sporadic violence between rebels in the region and government forces. The last time they spoke, her husband feared for the worst.
The main reason they were afraid and the main reason they really want to get out of that area is because of the fights that keep on erupting between the government and the rebels. When those fights erupt, it gets to a point everyone for himself. That means when it gets to where they are, where the governor is, the governor can't help or protect them anymore, especially because it now becomes war. It's now government and them, and probably also the government soldiers don't know who these people are. So it's going to be just full war, everyone for himself.
The two are not imprisoned and can walk about freely, but they cannot leave the area. They also get regular meals. For Captain Njoroge, however, things could get worse, requiring regular medication which cannot be found in the region. His health could get worse.
Where they are, they don't have the kind of medicine that he requires. The last time they took him to a clinic, he only got antibiotics because that's what's available in that place. But with the heat and the climate, it's really affecting them.
As the fate of the two continues to play out, the government claims that it is doing its best to secure their release. It says it is working with regional and international bodies such as IGAD, AU and the UN to put pressure on the rebels and their leader Riek Machar to release the pilots as negotiations with the insurance company and the owner of the plane is conducted. For Mudoni, her only hope now is that her husband of 14 years returns home to her and their three children. Meanwhile, the Kenya Airline Pilots Association has called for the release of the two, saying there is no need to detain them as talks on compensation are held. They have called on pilots to withhold flights into and within Upper Nile State until the two are released. Andrew Ochieng, NTV.